Welcome to the Royal Society and our exhibition Guardians of the Gut, and what I'm going to do now is just give you a quick tour of what's inside our giant interactive gut. So follow me. So first of all, we're at Meet Your Microbes. So these are the microbes that you actually find inside the gut, and each of these different microbes, which are a different colour, indicate a different type of bacterial species. So here we've got Lactobacillus, we've got Clostridium, we've got Prevotella, we have Roseburia, we've got E. coli, we've got Bacteroides, and the favourite bug that we work in the lab, which is Bifidobacterium. So these are, all these colours represent the different lights that are in the interactive gut. So let's go on inside and let's see what these bacteria are up to. So first of all, let's move through the villi. So, welcome. As you can see, it's a little bit dark in here, but what we're going to do is we've got interactive game stations that link back to how different factors influence the microbes that we have within the gut. So the first one is actually how you're born impacts what microbes you have. So if you're natural birth, you can see that we've got a number of different colours here, predominantly purple and green, which links back to Bifidobacteria and Lactobacillus, and those are the types of bacteria you get if you're born naturally. If you're a C-section baby, we've again still got some Lactobacillus and Bifidobacteria, but we've also got different types of bacteria. And this is because when you're born by cesarean section, the first types of microbes you come into contact with are actually skin microbes. So that's birth. What's next? Well, obviously, babies are on a milk-based diet before they move on to solid food. So let's look to see if bottle feeding or breastfeeding, what that does to your microbes. So if you're on formula, you can see that lots of different lights have lit up, which links back to lots of different types of bacteria that you have within the gut of babies that are bottle fed. But if you're a breastfed baby, let's have a look at the change of colours. So hopefully you can see that we've got lots of purple, which links back to Bif, which again is our favourite bacteria. And why have we got lots of purple in breastfed? That's because Bifidobacteria are actually able to digest components of breast milk that basically enables it to outcompete other types of bacteria. So we're on milk for a baby, obviously we're not when we're an adult, and let's look at good versus bad diets. So a bad diet, which links back to kind of lots of fats, lots of sugars, lots of processed foods. What types of bacteria do we have if we have that type of diet? Well, we've actually got lots of yellow here and we've got some white as well. So this is Bacteroides and Clostridium. And normally these bacteria are good, but if the balance is shifted, it can impact on your health. But if you've got a good diet, so that's lots of fruit and vegetables, one of the colours that kind of pops up is orange, and this links back to a particular bacteria called Roseburia, because Roseburia loves fibre. So it digests the fibre in our fruits and vegetables and provides us with beneficial compounds that are really important for our health. And onto the final station. So everybody knows that if you've got maybe a nasty infection, you go to the doctors for a course of antibiotics. So let's see what happens when we start an infection. Well, hopefully everyone can see that it's gone really yellow, so that means there's now a lot of Clostridium, and that's a Clostridium infection. So you might then go to your doctors in order to potentially kill the bacteria. So let's take a course of antibiotics. So this button here, let's just follow it, and let's look at the lights. So you can see the lights are beginning to go off because you've had your course of antibiotics, but you've not finished your course and your infection potentially comes back, which maybe links to the fact that these bacteria might be antibiotic resistant, which is why it's important to finish your course of antibiotics. So let's finish that course of antibiotics. Bear with me. This is why it's important to finish it. Watch all the lights turn off. What's important here is that all of the Clostridium has disappeared. We've also killed off some of our beneficial bacteria again. So finally, what we want to do is restore the balance in our beneficial bacteria. So let's hit the button. And hey presto, what we've got is a really nice balance of bacteria that brings us back to kind of a healthy microbial community. And then let's go out to the gut and figure out what type of research we're doing in the whole lab and how we're trying to make sure we have this balanced ecosystem. So the last part of the exhibit is basically actually linking back to some of the research we actually do in the lab, which is really exciting. So the first one we've actually got understanding how bifidobacteria actually helps program your immune system, and it does this in a number of different ways. We're also looking to understand how bifidobacteria can digest components of breast milk, and these are just some of the sugars that are in breast milk. And last, but certainly not least, we're actually trying to understand how bifidobacteria is able to resist infection. And the whole idea of this is actually to come up with new therapies that we can potentially give to kids in developing countries where infectious diseases are obviously a massive burden on society. And that's us, and that's a wrap.